I think I'm audible to all the participants.
Yeah, participants wise, we cannot able to listen.
Yeah, okay. Thank you, Ishwar, Dr. Ishwar, for giving me the opportunity. Thank you, Principal Sir. I think my voice is audible to all the participants as well as the panel members of this webinar. So here, hello everyone. Good evening to all the participants for this, the great webinar on the patent, drafting of a patent specification, as well as the procedure for obtaining a patent, Indian patent. On behalf of this management of Vigyan, Chairman Sir, Dr. Lavu Rathe Garu, Vice Chairman, Sri Krishna Devarayalu Garu, our beloved Principal, Srinivas Babu Garu, Dr. Srinivas Babu Garu, my teaching and non-teaching faculty of Vigyan, and on behalf of the students of Vigyan Pharmacy College, I feel a great honor to invite all the participants as well as our resource person, Dr. S.P. Subramanian, the Deputy Controller of Patents and Designs, Patents Office, Chennai. We are happy to inform you that nearly 1,000 members, more than 1,000 members have enrolled for this the great event, that is webinar on this patent drafting as well as procedure for obtaining a patent. And to obtain, to give the maximum benefit for all the participants, and whereas our Zoom is able to accommodate only 500 people, so we have now increased the capacity by giving a live YouTube link, and which can, already the link has been shared for every participant through their mail. So the objective is to give the maximum benefit for all the participants. So we are having a nearly around 1200, 1300 participants. So I think we are doing the best. And as you know, the part of the practices of this webinar, even though you all know about the general practices, what you follow in webinar, I feel myself responsible to tell you all some guidelines during this session. I request to please use earphones from the participants so that there won't be any disturbance of voice. Second thing is, we will enable the chat once when the session is going to be end within 10-15 minutes, so that in the chat section, so before 10-15 minutes of the presentation is going to complete, you can ask your queries so that our admin department as well as the resource person, Dr. Subramanian sir, will take over your questions and will try to answer based on the time and availability. Or I request the participants to raise their hands so that our one of the technical panel member, Elamandesaro sir, is already looking that same job, so that whoever the lifted hand, they will raise and they will note their name and try to inform the main admin so that you can have a direct discussion with our resource person, Dr. Subramanian sir. So we are all trying to provide you the best way to benefit all the participants in all the ways of whatever the possible ways that we have. And thank you once again. And don't forget to give the feedback once the session is over. The feedback link is already mailed to you from our IQHC coordinator, Dr. P. Saujanya madam. In the morning time, I think you may have all have this link for this, what we call this feedback session. So once after this session is over, please submit the feedback details, and so the done only you can avail the certificate of participation here. So once again, on behalf of the management, college, staff, students and everyone, I cordially welcome Dr. S.P. Subramanian sir to deliver his the great lecture on this drafting a patent specification and procedure for obtaining an Indian patent. Thank you all. Now I request our honorable beloved principal sir, Dr. P. Srinivas Babu Garu, to address the participants as well as give this valuable speech. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Vishwanath Garu. And first, I would like to thank Mr. Vishwanath and Saujanya Madam for making this a really, it's a true part of one of the wonderful webinar on the drafting patent application and procedure for filing a patent. On behalf of Vigyan Pharmacy College, I would like to thank our beloved Dr. S.P. Subramanian Garu for accepting, in spite of his busy schedule, for this webinar session. On behalf of all our staff members, we are very thankful to you, sir, for coming here and doing this a great job for most of the pharmacy faculty and students and various participants. Within 3 hours, the full 1,000 members was enrolled. So it is one of the great achievements. It's a very good topic. I congratulate Subramanian garu for this type of presentation. And on behalf of this, I would like to read out the Subramanian garu's resume briefly. Sir has done MSc Organic Chemistry and PhD in Pharmaceutical Sciences, and worked as a government analyst for 7 years in Central Drug Laboratory, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Kolkata. And for the past 18 years, he is working in the Patent Office, Chennai. And he is having the various work experiences, and also sir has various experiences related to how to grant a patent and application of fields, patent application of fields in India. And he has adjudicated many pre-grant and post-grant oppositions and patentability related matters, as well as quasi judicial authority, and issued many decisions submitted and referred in many higher courts. So many important patent cases, such as anti-cancer drugs, HIV drugs, are which are refused in India, even though it was granted more than 40 countries. So undergone training in Japanese Patent Office, Tokyo, on intellectual property rights. One of the members to attend the United Nations Council Standing Committee on Patents to negotiate the various matters pertaining to the patents on behalf of India. So he delivered lectures, attended several national and international seminars and workshops, and also is one of the member of expert group on patent facilitation program, CPAC, Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. Member of Patent Expert Committee in Pondicherry University, Annamalai University, and a panel expert in so many other universities. So with a very, we are very thankful to you, sir. So with a short span of time, so all the instructions which was given by our convener, Mr. Vishnu, so please, participants, please follow, and all the things we will assist you and guide you. And I request Dr. Subramanian garu to hand over the session. Thank you.
Good afternoon, respected principal and my friend Vishwanath and other faculty members of Vignan University and Pharmacy College, and various other principals and faculty members, professors and research scholars, those who are attending this webinar. I welcome my sincere greetings to them. This is very interesting topic for Indian inventors, particularly for the academic people. Many of the patent applications filed by Indian patent faculty members are refused from the patent office because of poor drafting. You are routinely doing the work, you are publishing your research work in the various journals and periodicals, but the similar way you have to draft a specification and file it properly to grant a patent, to get a grant from the patent office. So this topic is very important for all the faculty members and academic people, those who are doing research work. And the first question I received from the participants, what is the difference between the patent and copyright? Now, patent is a contract between the inventor and the society, government of India. For getting a monopoly right, he is disclosing his invention to the government of India. In view of that, government will grant a monopoly right for 20 years time. During this 20 years time, he is having the right to sell, to manufacture, to license it, to cross license it to the people. But for that, it is very important he has to disclose, he has to submit a written description. He need not produce any model to the patent office. He need not show any process or product to the patent office. He has to submit only the written description. That written description should sufficiently teach the technical field, the research work, so that people working in the field can make use of that invention after expiry of the patent or during the period, validity period, they can do further research and they can use this invention. For that, he has to give some best mode of practicing this invention. See, now everyone is under technical arrest, the COVID-19. It is very important. Still, many countries are struggling to find out a vaccine and also a drug. In olden times, it is very difficult to find out a drug for a particular disease. But nowadays, it is very easy. Now, in silico has come. If you find out a lead molecule and you can select the receptor, and very easily you can find out the molecule and thousands of molecule. And the activity also, the same time you can get from in silico, and you can do in vitro method, and you can go for a laboratory testing and phase one, phase two, phase three trials for before introducing your product in the market. I hope many people are participated here are pharma. I hope they will also try to find out to come out from this disease, even from the natural source or from the synthetic source. Most of the drugs which are available in the market are from the natural source, some are other source. Maybe it may be from plant source, or it may be from animal source, or it may be from any other source. So once you separate the active molecule from that natural source, but you should not say to the patent office that it is separated from the nature. Once you say it's separated from the nature, straight away we will say it is a discovery, because it is already available in the nature. But for that, we have to do some reverse engineering, and you have to say that it is synthesized from the laboratory, so that you will get a better protection for your molecule, for your separated new molecule from the source. Now the inventor will get 20 years monopoly right. During this 20 years period, he can develop his product and he can do more research on his work, and he can sell his invention, or he can license his invention in different places. ...90% of the inventions are improvements. If you take 100 applications, over 90% of the applications are for the improvements. Only that 10% of the applicants may be for new chemical entity, or maybe for new way of invention. Your invention may be an improvement to the known technologies. Say, for example, the first picture is acyclovir, and second picture is ganciclovir. The difference between acyclovir and ganciclovir, only one CH2 go OH group. The first inventor who invented acyclovir, he has also obtained a product patent, and he enjoyed 20 years period simply introducing one CH2 OH group, and he claimed it is a better drug, more efficiency than the acyclovir, and he said it's a multi or broad spectrum drug. So it may be the improvement of the known molecule, or combination of known technologies, or it may be using the known technologies for your invention. Say, for example, oxidation method is known in the art, and reduction is also known in the art. For your molecule, during synthesis, you can use that oxidation or a reduction method for converting any group into your desired group. And also, say for example, transferring a data. Transferring a data is already known in the earth. And encrypted data transfer, when you invent, then the data and the method of transmitting, everything is known in the earth. But now you are doing only the encryption. And you can characterize the invention. It is the new uses of the known technologies. That's why I said 90% of the inventions are incremental. And whenever you decide to file a patent application, you should know what is the invention. Invention according to section 21J of the Act, any new product or process capable of industrial application involving an inventive step is called invention according to section 21J. And also you should know what are all the things patentable, whether certain things are not patentable. That also under section 3E3, section 3 clearly says for pharmacy, it is section 3B, 3C, 3D, 3E, 3I, and 3P is very important. In pharma related cases, 3B, if anything injurious to human health is not patentable subject matter. Say for example, introducing BT sequence in the cotton plant and making a seed, it is injurious to the insects. So this type of patent inventions are not patentable in India. According to section 3C, anything if you separate from nature, say for example, any new molecule, you can separate from a plant source or from the animal source, and you can test it for a particular ailment. And this separating the molecule is not patentable. According to 3C, you will not get a product patent, but you will get a process patent. I told you, in such a cases, people working in herbal drugs or people working in a pharmacognosy department, they routinely separate the active molecule from the herbal or other sources. What do you do? Once you identify the molecule and you found out all the structure elucidation, then you do the reverse engineering and find out a synthetic way of preparing the molecule and file a product patent in the synthetic mode. If you say this molecule is already separated from any herbal source, you will not get a product patent, you will get a process patent. I'll tell you what is the difference between a process patent and product patent. A product patent means for reaching the particular product, if you approach any route, any method of manufacturing that product, they have to take a permission from you. Say for example, you have invented a paracetamol molecule, a simple molecule. Now, you are protected under product patent. Anybody want to use that paracetamol, they have to take your permission. Now, you have only filed a patent for method for preparing paracetamol. Any A person or B or C, any other person can come out with a different method for preparing such paracetamol and they can file a patent. So in the process patent, there are many players can come and file a patent. In case of product patent, you'll be the only person, monopoly, you can enjoy 20 years period. So in foreign countries, in all universities or in research institutes, they separate the molecule like this. They never say it is separated from the natural source. They find out a lead synthetic method and they file as if the molecule is synthesized in the laboratory. I hope all the people working in the natural products and pharmacognosy or herbal drugs, now they can understand and how to file a patent applications so that you can escape from section 3D. Section 3D is also very important section as far as a drug patent is concerned. Any new form of a known substance is not patentable. Any new form of a known substance. Already one molecule, say for example penicillin, is filed, it is expired. Now any people can come out with the new crystalline form, polymer A, polymer B, polymer C. They file a patent and they file for a metabolite, they file for enantiomer, they file for a isomer, they file for a composition. Such a molecules are considered as a same substance unless there is a improved efficacy. Improved efficacy means it should have improved pharmacodynamic activity. It is not pharmacodynamic activity. I said it is not pharmacokinetic activity. It should have a pharmacodynamic activity. That means it should have the improved desired effect. Right? So that is the difference between the molecule, the old molecule come into a new molecule for getting 20 years monopoly, because they enjoy 20 years for the original molecule and they enjoy 20 years for this polymorph and another 20 years for a metabolite and another 20 years for isomers. Section 3D takes care if any such molecule, they file a patent application in India jurisdiction, they have to show the efficacy. But you can file it in US, you can obtain a patent, because US Act allows this type of inventions. And in section 3D, second part says, any new use of a known substance, say for example, aspirin. Aspirin, earlier it was used as a non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. Very recent times, we are using, it's a cardiovascular drug. So it's a second use of the known drug. If you take any drug, it possesses more than one activity. During the clinical trial, they design the activity, whatever the activity predominates, and the reduced toxicity, then they use for the particular activity or particular ailment. Therefore, the activity we are for, which we observed
excuse
now
me, sir.
For
Subramaniam sir, excuse me, yes, sir. Sorry for yes, the difference.
Yes.
Sir, can you please share your screen? Actually, you have turned off that screen sharing.
Is
can
it?
You please? Yeah, sir. Myself is sharing the screen, but I cannot able to. I mean, keep the slide. What you are saying and what am I?
No,
keeping.
before drafting.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Once you slide. Share the screen, please. Yes, sir. Just go for share screen.
Now.
And also, your voice is somewhat less audible, sir.
Is it less audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sorry for the disturbance.
No, it's okay because
So many people are listening to you, sir. Okay. Already 500 plus are already there. Yeah, just share your
is it screen. Audible now?
Yes, sir. Just a little bit loud, sir. Little bit loud. Sorry.
Okay.
Just to share the screen, sir. Or you can do one thing, sir. I will share the screen. Please let me know next, like that. By that also, I can do the chart. Or otherwise, you can share the screen. So previously, you have done very well, but now your picture is only coming. Your video is only coming, but the screen is not visible to us, the PowerPoint presentation screen. Yeah. Sir, now you have opened the Word document, sir. Better open that PowerPoint presentation. Is it PowerPoint? Yes, sir. Now you go for slideshow. Or F5 simply you can press, sir. F5, function 5. Yes, sir. Yes, okay. Sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Now
thank you.
Visible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sorry for the disturbance. No, now you can press it, sir. Now you can
press it. Is it audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Audible, sir.
Sorry for the interruption to all the participants. It's a technical problem.
Yeah.
Now, I discuss section 3D, second use of the known drug. It is about aspirin. Can everyone hear? Is it audible now? Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, the second use of the known substance. Now, aspirin, I said, as an example, it is first used as an anti-inflammatory drug, and second, now we are using it cardiovascular drug. And second use of the known substance in India, not patentable. In other jurisdictions like Europe or America, it is patentable. Suppose if you come across such an invention in India, avoid filing a patent in India and try to file it in Europe or in US, you will get a better protection. Or for that, you have to take a permission from Government of India and submit a written description to the Government of India before filing any application outside India. That I'll discuss later. And before drafting your specification, I said you should know what is invention and whether my invention is patentable or not. Suppose you are coming out with a composition, maybe a two ingredient, maybe herbal ingredient, or with any other chemical substances with that. While preparing such a composition, and you should show the synergetic activity, unforced inactivity. Number one, you have to test for individual drugs for that particular activity. And in combination, you have to test. If the combination gives more than the additive value of the individual drugs, then it is patentable. We can say it is an improved unforeseen effect. Otherwise, this mixture will be considered as an admixture and you will not get a patent. And there may be chance of refusing from the patent office. And section 3I, if any invention related to treatment or any, it may be a surgical method or diagnostic method, it is not patentable, except microorganism, any other living things is not patentable in India. And before the fourth and important aspect before filing, you have to do is prior art search and prior disclosure. And many of the academics, as soon as they complete the work, there may be a compelling situation. They have to submit their thesis. For that, they need a publication. They immediately communicate to an ordinary journal or a high impact journal for showing that it is published for their research work. And before doing such a work, please file your patent application. Then you communicate to any journal. In later stage, you cannot file a patent application for your own invention. Your publication will form a part of prior art and you will not get a patent because that research work will affect the novelty. And while drafting the patent application, the first and foremost work you have to do is search and where to search. And many of the people we do Google search and Google patent search. And many do not know there is the patent database. It is free of cost, 24/7. You can access, you can get latest information. But in case of any periodicals or journals, most of the time it publishes discoveries. But in the patent database, most of the time you get inventions. Therefore, it is very important to conduct your search in the patent database rather than any other periodicals
or people use Science Direct or any other thing. Most of the time, you can see all the developed countries, they publish the discoveries. Our Indian academicians, they publish knowingly or unknowingly inventions. They never bother about filing the patent application. They simply disclose their important research work in the public domain. People working in that field make use of that research work and they develop little bit, they file a patent, they get monopoly right. The creator is from India. They develop the research work. They do not know to protect the research work. Somewhere, somebody sitting in the corner, after seeing the research work, he do thorough search and he develop and some value addition he do and file a patent application. So therefore, for publications, you have to take care and conducting search you have to do in the patent database. And before doing search, you have to list out the problem. What are all the problems you are going to solve? Or what are all the problems in the prior art in the particular, say for example, for treating a cancer, for treating HIV, for treating COVID-19. And find out, list what are all the problems in the prior art. There may be many inventions. That invention may not work, some or other reason. And you have to list out the problem and you have to give a solution from your invention. And you have to try to give solution. And while giving a solution, and you should ensure that whether this solution, this research work is novel, whether it is already published in any of the corner of the world or in any other language, maybe in Japanese language, maybe German language, or maybe Chinese language. And you have to check, and there are mechanisms, the patent database, you can very easily check the novelty. And also you have to check obviousness. It may be a combination from the 2-3 documents. Maybe one of the component may be published in one research work. Other part may be published in the second paper. Other part is published in the 3 paper. And a person skilled in the art, they can combine and he can file a single patent application. Say for example, you want to synthesize a drug, you want to manufacture a drug. 3 steps are there. First step is disclosed in one paper, and second step is disclosed in another paper. Third step is disclosed in a patent. And combining these 3, you cannot file a patent because it is obvious to a person skilled in the art. That also you have to ensure before filing the patent application. And also you have to ensure whether you are going to file a provisional application or a complete application, or you are going to extend your application in other nations, that also you have to decide before filing your patent applications. Now I said patent database. Patent database, patent information, it's a unique source of technical information which is not disclosed in any other form, in any other model. 80% of the details available in the patent database is not available in any other form. Say for example, television first time published in 1923 in patent document, and later it was published in 1928. It took 3 years to publish in any other form. In it may be in the journal or it may be in the newspaper or any other form. Jet engine related invention first published in the patent document in 1936, but it took 10 years to disclose in any other form. So therefore, patent database, you will get the latest information. So therefore, I request all of you to use this patent database for your research work. 80%, I said, only published in the patent document, and only 10% published in the periodical, in other research communications, any other thing. So whenever you are starting any research work in future, please try in the patent database. Out of this, 90% of the documents are free to use.
why this 90% of the documents are free to use? Because 90% is already in the public domain. Only 10% is in the patent term. Even the 10% also for research work, you can make use and you can file your patent. Almost 100% of the details in the research work, in the patent database, you can make use for your research work. I prefer, with our experience in the patent office, European patent database gives collective information. It is a combination of more than 68 countries' patent details you can get in the patent database, European patent database. If you want to search US patent office, Canadian, Australian, all European, Chinese, Japanese, Korean, all these details, you will get it from the European patent database. You can download as a PDF document. Suppose the invention is related to computer science, or maybe a transmitter, or it may be antenna. Definitely these informations, whatever published in the Japanese patent office or Chinese patent office, we can download the entire details as well as the drawings, diagrams. If it is in the Chinese document, there is an online translation. You can translate and you can take a printout or you can copy. So therefore, use the European patent database for your research work. Patent searching is not easy. Even driving also not easy if you take the first day drive, right? So patent searching also is not easy on the first day, because people, they publish the information, they disclose the information, at the same time, they hide the information from the public or from the competitor or from people working in that field. So therefore, you have to use the various keywords to retrieve the important document related to your research work. Suppose if you want to search for an automatic razor, that information may not be available under automatic razor, or it may be found in any other form. It may be shaver or de-airing device or hair removing device or even unairing device. Therefore, all the possible keywords you have to use. Suppose you want to search for aspirin, the information may not be available under acetyl salicylic acid or maybe under aspirin. It may be published in the IUPAC name of the drug, or it may be published in any other form. It is like an anti-inflammatory agent or cardiovascular drug. So you have to find out all the options. And now there are two types of searches in the search. One is keyword search. Another one is IPC, International Patent Classification. Keywords, it is not easy to retrieve the document. And if you know the technique, it is very easy. Why? The applicants, the inventors, for legal implications, they hide the information. For better protection, they normally don't use common word. Say, for example, you want to search for a bicycle. The information may not be published in bicycle. It may be as a transport device. It's a common synonym, you can say, or a definition for a bicycle, you can say. But people try to use the equivalent word, not the same word, whatever you are using regularly. So therefore, you have to, when searching, you have to find out the suitable keywords. And in case of IPC, each category of the subject is classified in different classifications. If the invention related to agriculture, biotechnology, drugs, or engineering, computer science, or mechanical engineering, or any other field, all are classified into separate category. In the separate category, there is a subclass, there is a sub-subclass. So if you know the subclass or sub-subclass, whatever invention published as on date, you can retrieve all the documents. It may be filed in the European Patent Office, or it may be filed in US patent office, or it may be filed in Korean patent office, or any other patent, even Malaysian patent office. All these documents you can download and retrieve. Fine. So IPC will give you very good search result, and try to practice even IPC also. Over a period of time, you can understand. If you take the publication of the first page of any patent publication, there is applicant name, inventor name, and one column states International Patent Classification, or it may be in the abbreviated form, maybe IPC. That check the IPC and copy and paste, you will get the result. Very easy method. There are websites for searching, filing a patent application, for searching a patent application filed in India. You can use the first link, ipindia.nic.in. For the document filed and published in World Intellectual Property, that is PCT applications, or we can call it as an international application, we can search it in WIPO. For applications filed worldwide, maybe in the European office, or it may be US office, patent office, all the details are available worldwide.hpsnet.com. And for searching in USPTO, you can use the last link. Now, the topic is drafting your patent specification. I said many applications from the Indian inventor are refused at the time of prosecution of this application in the patent office because of poor drafting. The drafting, that's why I stress, stressing is very, very important. The drafting a specification is very, very important. Now, you are preparing a patent document and it is already submitted in the patent office. There are many people make use of the document. Number one, patent office will read the document at the time of filing the patent applications for the classification. And during prosecution, and the examiner will go through your specification and search and submit a report to the controller. And then controller will go through the specification and send the gist of application, the objection, as a first examination report to the inventor or to the applicant. Then any people interested, any person interested can file pre-grant opposition after the publication. The opponent will go through it. The people working in that particular field will also go through the document and file a opposition. And if you want to license your invention, or if you want to sell your invention outright, those people will read the specification whether the document is having full protection for the 20 years. Suppose you want to sell a house. If it is near the forest, nobody will come and purchase. If you make a full fence and with all the protections, then people may think to buy. For that, people will go through the document, any licensee or assignee, whether the document is having a full protection, whether all the technical details are disclosed, whether the patent office is approved or not, all these details will, they will also check before they purchase your invention. Suppose anybody file revocation of your application in the IPAB or in counter, we can file an infringement suit in the court. Both sides of the advocate will go through, and the court judge will go through. So the court proceedings, all the people involved in the court proceedings, they will read the specification. And skilled person working in the research corner, say maybe the drug is related to HIV. People working in the HIV field, all the people, they will go through the document and they find out the possibility of doing further research in that. And competitor, already they are in the market, they are selling the drug.
they will also go through the document. Is there any loophole to file a opposition and to refuse your application or revoke the patent in the patent office or in the IPAB? They will also check. And finally, the general public will read. Once the patent term is expired, this will come into the public domain. Once it is come to the public domain, people can make use of that invention. They also start manufacturing so that it will become a generic medicine. So general public also will read. So it is more important. Many people are reading this document. So take at least utmost care before drafting your specification. There are two type of specifications. A written description you have to submit to the patent office. One is provisional and other one is complete. The name provisional itself shows that it's a provisional. It is temporary. It is valid for 1 year. If you don't file a complete within 12 months or 1 year, automatically it will be abandoned. I'll discuss the provisional later. Patent specification is a techno-legal document. It is a technical as well as legal document. Whatever you are publishing in the journal, it's a purely scientific and technical matter in that. But in the patent document, they mix the legal wordings also so that you will get the protection. Why it's a techno-legal document? It is a property registration. It is not simply scientific publication. It is a property registration. You are protecting your knowledge in the patent office. You can enjoy that for the next 20 years. Say, for example, if you are having a house, maybe in Hyderabad or maybe in Delhi, you can enjoy wherever it is. If you invent a molecule or if you invent a device for detecting COVID-19, then you can enjoy your invention worldwide. You can enjoy throughout India. You can sell your product. You can yourself can sell your product in US, or you can give license to your product in Europe, or you can give license to a manufacturer in other country, China or Japan. So therefore, at the same time, you are enjoying the right worldwide. This is a property registration. So therefore, it is a technical as well as legal. So people working in the field, professionals, they know how to protect, how to mix this technical with legal. And if you also try to work for time, then you can also acquaint it and you can do it very easily. The patent specification should describe all the technical feature of the inventions at the time of filing in the provisional specification or in the complete specification. But the provisional specification do not contain any claim. It is only technical details with working examples. But filing the application decides the data priority, the data protection. Whatever cause will happen in future, it depends upon the data filing and also the disclosure, whatever you have disclosed. Now you may think that, so this information is sufficient for the patent office. More than this, it's not sufficient. So simply you submit the document with the minimum information. But at the time of opposition, then the opponent may ask, all the details for granting a patent is not disclosed or it is already disclosed in the prior art document. So therefore, you disclose all the details as much as possible, because in future you can amend your technical details under section 57 or 59 of the Act within the scope of the first disclosure. Beyond that, you cannot do it. Say, for example, if you would have disclosed solvent, in future, you can add many number of solvent in that, because that generic information is already there. If they say, for example, the invention may be related to engineering, fastener, fastening means. If you introduced a fastening means in the first filed application, in future, you can add many fastening means. If there is no word fastening means or a solvent, you cannot add anything further related to that. So therefore, it is very important for all the key points and key words and phrases at the time of filing the applications. So therefore, draft in detail and submit the application. What are all the occasions to file these patent applications? When there is urgency, suppose somebody want to submit their thesis, they can do it. Or 2 or 3 persons working in this office, in the laboratory or in the college, leaving that college and going to join in another company. That time you have to submit, or otherwise he will go and submit this work in other area. So there is urgency, or accidentally you have disclosed in any seminar and people as a observer in the seminar or a participant may make use of this disclosure and immediately they can file a patent application. There are many incidents happened like this. I'll tell you, whoever asked separately, there are many incidents happened this disclosure in the seminar. Before disclosing any detail related to your research work, file a patent application and disclose. If you are going to publish it in a journal, fine, you can go and disclose in any meeting or any seminar or in any poster presentation. If you decide you want to file a patent applications, then don't disclose the matter openly in any seminar or anywhere. But disclosing to the government for a fund will not come under this. Okay, you need not worry. And if you would have disclosed with the competitor during discussion without NDA, whenever you are going to discuss any technical matter, anybody outside your laboratory, ask them to sign NDA, non-disclosure agreement. It is a binding on the people. It may be you are doing some other research work, or you may ask for a financial help from other people. You have to disclose your invention. On such occasions, you ask the people before disclosing the detail, NDA. NDA is very important. There are many templates are available in the website. You can download and you can edit and you can use it as you wish, as per your requirement. The validity of the provisional specification, I said, it is 12 months. Suppose today you are filing your application 10-5-2020. You have to submit your application's complete specification within 12 months from the date of filing. That is 10-5-2021. If you don't file, you are missing the bus. Automatically, this application will be abandoned. You will not get this priority date, but you can file your applications again. But the priority date you will not get, this priority date 10-5-2020, whatever date you are going to submit in future, that date only you will get. In between, if anybody submitted patent application, they will get the patent for this particular invention. So please take care. This timeline is very important for filing the patent application. You have submitted your application in the patent office as a complete specification. Then you can request the controller within 12 months to convert the complete specification into provisional specification, and you can file your complete specification with the improvement within 12 months. Now, complete specification. This is a very important topic, drafting of complete specification. Now, we have come to a core area. The complete specification is divided into two major parts. One is description, another one is claim. Description is for describing the invention, and claim is the monopoly part, is the protection part. The claim only give you protection for 20 years. You are the owner. The claim only decides what you want to protect. Suppose you are having a say for 5 acres of land. You are making a fence for 1 acre. That means you want to protect only the 1 acre, and remaining you are allowing the public to make use of it.
but you may have disclosed many things in the description. Whatever you are claiming, that only you are going to protect it for 20 years. So therefore, claim drafting is also very, very important while filing the applications. According to Section 10(4) of the Act, the invention should fully and particularly describe the invention. Fully and particularly means whatever the technical field you want to protect, all the details related to that field, that research work, you have to disclose in the specification. In later stage, you cannot add anything because it will be considered as later acquired knowledge. Patent is granted for the knowledge known to the applicant on the date of filing the applications, right? If you file later stage, then it will be considered as a later acquired knowledge. Within 12 months, if anything happened like that, then there is another remedy that, if required, I'll discuss later. So best method of performing the invention also you have to disclose in the specification. Why? It is an enabling disclosure. When the patent period is over or the specification in the public domain, people make use of the disclosure and they start the method disclosed for manufacturing a particular product. So you have to disclose the best method of performing your invention in the detail. You may ask, sir, that is my invention. Why should I disclose the best mode of performing the invention? See, the contract between you and the government is you have to disclose to your invention to the government. You are not going to give anything to the government. But in lieu of that, government is going to give a monopoly right for 20 years. For that, these are all mandatory. You have to disclose. You cannot hide anything. But the know-hows, you should not disclose. Say, for example, the particular way of doing only, you will get maximum yield. Maybe you may use the same solvent, or you may use the same chemical, or you may be the same environment. Whether the substance is added to the solvent or salt is added to the substance makes the difference. Simple example. So this type of know-how, it should be always with you. Then only you can protect your invention, some of the know-hows with you. And it should end with the claim defining the scope of the protection. Now, the complete specification is having different subheadings. Like your research work, in the research work, you have the abstract, you have the introduction, materials and methods, result and discussion, conclusion. All this part you are having in the periodicals for publication in the journal. A similar way, in the complete specification, it should be title, it should have a title. There is a description of the invention. You have to describe and define the invention and claims. It is a part of the description and the claim should have a support in the description and drawings wherever it is necessary. The invention related to any engineering inventions or sometimes in the chemical inventions, the drawings are very much important and it should end with the abstract. These are all subheading. Now, title of the invention. The job of the title is to indicate the subject matter. As soon as I read the title, I should understand the subject matter, what subject matter the inventor want to protect. It should be within 15 words. It should not be very lengthy, maybe 50 words or a paragraph. Title should be precise within 15 words. Somebody, it's a practice of the academic people. They want to give everything in the title. So I have seen many such applications. Suppose you want to make a composition for treating cancer. And in addition to that, the many things are there. But we want, at the time of filing, simple composition is enough. Or combination is enough. Or composition for treating cancer It gives full define, full detail. Say, for example, improved electrical switch. Could you find anything from this title? It's an improvement. There is an improvement in the switch. But the right title is an electrical switch for use in the domestic lighting circuit. We have specifically disclosed what the invention is related to. So therefore, the second one clearly states the title. First one is not. Most of the time, the people enjoying the monopoly right, patent holders, they use the first title. Why? Title is a part first published in the journal, right? So therefore, they want to give minimum information so that divert the people not concentrated on your invention to avoiding the opposition and other things. Second example, the engine may be used for preparing a juice, apple juice, right? Normally people use engine. The right way of using the title is apple juice powered engine. I prefer, I recommend use the first one so that at the time of examination, you may get a receive objection from the examiner or from the controller. That time you can amend. There is a possibility to amend the title at the time of examination, at the time of prosecution. So therefore, title don't give broad. In the content of this description, further description, field of invention, background of invention. In the background of invention, there are prior art details, object of the invention. These two you have to discuss in the background information. And statement of invention, detailed description with working examples and drawings. These are in the detailed description. Now, at the starting of the complete specification, the description, first part is the field of invention, technical field. This is required for the examiner to understand, to classify your application. Suppose the invention related to biotechnology, he will mark this application is belong to biotechnology so that it will be sent to the biotechnology examiner and the controller at the time of examination. And if the invention related to pharma, he will mark pharma, he classify as pharma, then at the time of examination, it will be allotted to the pharma experts. So it is very important to show the technical field, to start with the technical field. Say, for example, the invention in the field of, you have to start like this and you introduce your title, whatever you want to introduce, apple juice powered engines. Now, another way of starting, the invention related to apple juice powered engines, more particularly, if there is a specific embodiment, you can add here. And there are third option. The present invention is directed to apple juice powered engines, more particularly, and whatever the embodiments you want to add, you can do. What are all the prior arts? Say today you are going to file a patent application, whatever published prior to today, this date is formed part prior art. So you have to give a right brief write-up on the closely related prior arts, not all the prior arts. Suppose your invention related to, say for example, some particular cancer, colon cancer. Whatever the invention related to the colon cancer, you describe here. And if something relevant is there, you can give us a prior art, breast cancer or any other cancer. So therefore, some brief write-up we have to give. And whatever the problems in the prior art, they have not attended in the prior art, that also you have to disclose. And these problems is not met by the earlier inventions. Therefore, your object, you want to give a solution with the what solution you are going to give. That also you have to give. And if the object is one, it is okay, one object. Maybe two, three objects, two different objects, you can give that objects in the prior art. So it is very clear in the prior art, in the background information, that we call it as in the patent document, it's a background information. In the background information about the drug, about the field of the research work, and the documents whatever published, even in the patent document or in the journal, please discuss on the problem in the prior arts and solution, whatever object you are going to give, all these things you have to give. The next part, statement or summary of the invention. Here, whatever the embodiments you want to claim, you want to protect, you have to give it in brief. So whenever the examiner or experts will read your specification, they first read the abstract. Then they go to summary of invention or statement of the invention for understanding your invention. Then only they will go to the claim. So the statement of the invention is very important. All the embodiments, all the parts, all the different parts of your invention shall be disclosed here briefly, sometimes in detail. All the terms used shall be very clearly, you have to discuss here in the statement of invention. Say, for example, you are going to manufacture a drug, new molecule, new API, and you have to give that your aim is, the aspect of the invention is to manufacture a new drug, and process for preparing that API, that is the second embodiment, and using the drug, you are going to make a composition so that you can give it as a dose or dosage form to the people, that composition. With the drug, you are going to add one more drug available in the market. So that combination, possible combination, also another embodiment you can use. And use of the drug also you can mention. So these statements, you have to make it in the statement of invention. Then it is a detailed description. This is very important area. This should give all the support. Suppose you are having a piece of land, your house, lawn, back area and side area, playground, everything is there. All these things you have to discuss in the detailed description. Starting from A to Z related to your invention have to be discussed here. Suppose you are using some terminologies, pharmaceutically accepted excipients or pharmaceutically cosmetically accepted excipients. That time, you have to give a definition. What is pharmaceutically accepted excipients? Sometimes in the engineering field, the means for transmitting. What is the means for transmitting? It is a transmitter. What type of transmitter? What it is doing? This definition you have to give. Well, starting the detailed description. And it should give the enabling disclosure and best method of working the invention. All the parts, all the flow of methods, all the details, and best method of performing, and test results, more particularly test results you have to give. Suppose the invention is related to a composition. All the preparing the composition, and in vivo, in vitro activity, and the results obtained, and inference for the improved pharmacodynamic activity that you have to give. Therapeutic activity you have to show if it is a known drug, or if it is a combination, you have to give the activity for the result for each drug, and then combination, and what is the additive value, and for the combination, you have to compare and you have to give your imprint. And if you do any analytical work, any instrumental work, the graphs, diagrams, and then with the results, you can make a diagram, and the diagram should be in the diagram part, and the results should be tabulated, and the inference you have to give in the detailed description part, so that the examiner and controller can understand the invention and the importance of the invention and the various inventive feature of the invention before granting your patent specification. In the details description, you can give a illustration, tables, graphs, diagrams for sufficiently for the skilled person to understand your invention. Drawings are at most important for the mechanical invention, electrical and electronic inventions. And in case of biotechnology, the sequence listing is very important to understand whether the sequence listing is already disclosed and how much percentage it is disclosed, whether 100% is disclosed or 90% is disclosed, the matching for matching it should you have to give. And very less important in the field of chemical and pharmaceutical related invention drawings. But if it is various parts you have disclosed, maybe isometric view or cross-sectional view, you have to give unique notation for each part. Suppose the invention related to a transport vehicle, say for example, wheel. If you mark wheel as a number one, the entire document, even it may be, the wheel may be there more than 5 drawings or 10 drawings, the unique notation, one number shall be used whenever you are marking wheel. So unique notation we have to use. And there should not be any descriptive matter in the drawing. You can mark as a number and you can refer that number and describe in the description. There should not be any descriptive matter in the drawings, but all the description should be in the, say for example, you have to mark 1, 2, 3, and this 1, 2, 3 shall be discussed in the description. In the left-hand side, you have to give a name of the applicant or application number, right-hand side, total number of sheet number, end with signature of the applicant or the attorney. Then the last part of the complete specification, claims. Claim, I said, very important. It is making a boundary for your invention. Technical boundary, so that nobody can trespass the technical details, whatever you have marked. The claim will say, limit the monopoly and making boundaries. And very importantly, you might have disclosed in the description, but you have not, if you have not claimed, it means it is disclaimed. Even in the later stage also, according to section 59.1, you cannot add. Because whatever the claims disclose, within that only you can amend. If not disclose, then definitely we understood from the patent office, it is disclaimed. The claims should relate to one invention. According to the Patent Act, one invention, one patent, and all the claims, if you take claim 1 or claim 2, claim 3, it shall be a single sentence. In between, you can use comma, semicolon, but there should not be any full stop. It may run into 1 page or 2 page or 3 page, no problem. But there should not be any full stop in between in the claim. If claim 1 starts means, in between claim 1, there should not be any full stop. You can use semicolon or comma, right? The claim should be clear and concise. It should be supported by the description. If it is not supported at the time of examination, it will be struck out and the controller will object to delete it. Claim 1 is called principal claim. Claim 1 should define all the inventive feature of the invention. All the details shall be disclosed. The preferred feature may be in the dependent claim. There are many types of claim. For example, product claim, maybe device or apparatus, composition or article of manufacture, new chemical entity, or method for manufacturing, or method for transferring data, or method, any kind of method is patentable. And these are all the different type of invention which is available for filing a patent. In the claim, there are different three parts in the claim. First part is preamble. It gives you the detail about the invention. There is a transitional phrase, maybe comprising or consisting of. There are many other characteristics that are consisting essentially thereof. Many phrases are there, but commonly used phrases are comprising and consisting. It says, the preamble says about the invention and the claim body about your technical details. Preamble may be drug A for treating cancer, comprising step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be your invention. Now, simple example, let me discuss on the bicycle. At the time of discussing the search, I said, people don't disclose the commonly used words. The claim is related to, the invention is related to bicycle, but the inventor or the applicant prefer to claim as a transport device. He has not claimed as a bicycle or cycle. A transport device for human being is preamble, characterized by is a phrase, connecting phrase, and the A, B, C, D, all related to claim on, this is the body of claim. These are the technical features. Now, whenever you draft your specification, all the technical details, including the constructional and functional features, shall be disclosed in this. Let me discuss what are all the constructional and functional features. A, two or more wheels. Now, bicycle is having two wheels. The inventor claimed two or more wheels. It means he wanted to protect if anybody come out in future with a three wheel or four wheel or five wheel, it is better than the bicycle, then this patent document will take care, because he is claiming two or more wheels, because it's a broad claim. B, at least one wheel lying in front of the other wheel or wheels, a frame to which the wheels are rotatably connected. See here, he would have said wheels are connected. Instead, he said wheels are rotatably connected. It is a functional feature. The wheel is connected by means where it can be rotated. The connection may be any means, but the condition is the wheel is rotatably connected. A manually operable bar arranged to change the position of the front wheel in respect of the rear wheel or wheels, whereby transport device can be steered. See, manually operable bar. We say handlebar, bicycle. This is commonly used word. In the patent document, he used manually operable bar arranged to change the position. So he used the phrase, it's a separate word, so that people, anybody search, then they cannot get this, retrieve this document. To hide the document, they use some different wordings. D, foot operable means to cause the rotation of at least one wheel. Foot operable means pedal. They never claim as a pedal. It's a commonly used language. He discussed it's a foot operable means. That means always people, while submitting the patent document, they use most of the time not commonly used language, and there is a specific word they are using to hide the information. This claim one is called principal claim. All the details related to the invention is disclosed. Now claim 2, 3, 4 are narrowing down the invention, or the dependent claims to the claim one. If anything not disclosed in the claim one, they cannot claim in the claim 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Now claim 2 is according to claim one, that is depending on the claim one, there are two wheels arranged in front and the rear wheels in the same plane. See, now they say at least two wheels, they said. Now, one by one, it is arranged in the same plane. In case of bicycle, the two wheels are in the same plane. In case of tricycle, three wheels are in three different planes. So he narrowed down and specifically mentioned it is in the same plane. Claim 3. A transport device according to claim 2, in which a foot operable means is arranged to cause the rotation of the rear wheel. In the claim 1, at least one wheel they use, whether it's a front wheel or back wheel, no, they have not mentioned. Suppose if anybody come out which causes the rotation of the front wheel, then this claim will take care, because in the principal claim he has mentioned at least one wheel. But he is narrowing down, it is causing the rotation of the rear wheel. Claim 4. A transport device according to preceding claim, in which the front and rear wheels are equal diameter. Both the wheels in the bicycle or equal diameter. Therefore, all the inventive features are disclosed in the climb one. This is the way of climbing. Another example, let me give, and then I'll go to further examples how Indian inventors are climbing. Now you could find four figures at the bottom. All are cutting device. Now you see the preamble in the climb, a cutting device. All four are cutting device. Comprising is the phrase, and this is body of the climb. A metal blade having a cutting edge. In all the first three, all the four, metal blade having a cutting edge, all the four. A handle attached to the metal blade. First three, handle are attached to the blade. So, the climb is drafted in such a way that it is not only protecting his invention, he is protecting many future invention also, which will fall within his climb. So therefore, at the time of drafting, you have to draft in a broader way, let the patent office narrow down. Now, another process climb, a sieving method, a method for joining two pieces of cloth together at their edges. Now, the invention related to method of joining two pieces of the cloth together, comprising, that is a phrase, and step one, providing set two pieces of the cloth and positioning them together so that an edge portion of one piece overlap an adjacent edge portion of the other piece. Now, the steps A, B, starting with continuous. Whenever you are making your method of manufacturing any drug or method of preparing a particular compound, method of preparing a paracetamol, method of preparing aspirin, whenever these steps are you are writing, use continuous. Providing, pausing, mixing, all this continuous word you have to use for, that is the right way of doing. Step B, passing a thread repeatedly through and along the length of the overlapping portions in sequentially opposite directions and through sequentially spaced hole in the overlapping adjacent, whereby say two pieces of the cloth will be attached along the edge portions. Now, stitching the two portions, how they climb, you please go through it. This is the way you have to frame the climbs. Now, a composition, say for example, novel synergetic herbal composition. The red portion is the preamble. The comprises or comprising is the connective word or a phrase. Now, the ingredients present in the composition may be in percentage or maybe sometimes in milligram like this. So, each claim start with the preamble and connecting word, that is phrase, and then a body of the claim. Now, let me come to the example patent application filed by the inventor. This patent application filed by Indian inventor, application number 6188CHE 2013. This application is filed in Chennai Patent Office. Claim 1. I said all the technical detail shall be incorporated in the claim 1. Disclosed in the claim 1. I shown in the bicycle. Now, see. A multifunctional chair is capable of instantly convert into bed. We understand it is a multifunctional chair. It can be used as a bed or chair. Right? It can be converted. What are all the other details, other parts, constructional feature and functional feature not disclosed in the claim 1? See section, claim 2. As claimed in claim 1, wherein the means that the multifunctional chair has a back frame, also the provision attached to actuator, and all the details related invention, either inventive features are in the dependent claim. Therefore, these dependent details shall be incorporated in the claim 1 to form the principal claim. So this is poorly drafted claim because the inventive features of these inventions are claimed in the different claim. but in the dependent claim should claim the optional features, not the inventive features. Therefore, this has to be drafted in different way, incorporating all the inventive feature in the claim. Now, this is another claim. The product liquid potassium plus comprising. Do you understand what he want to protect? The product liquid potassium. Maybe the product may be a liquid potassium. And he used the connecting word, potassium 33%.
Sir, I know
solubility.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Claimed the solubility pH. This physical parameter and chemical parameter you cannot claim. You should not claim. Right? A physical parameter and chemical parameter you should not disclose, and size also you should not disclose. If the product is related to a liquid potassium, you have to give how the liquid potassium is, how you are preparing, and see claim 1, 2, 3, and claim 2, the use of this and with some buffering agents he has disclosed, all this combination he has to claim in claim 1. Now, another claim, 1226CHE 2014, I said principal claim should disclose on the inventive features. Now, he claimed it is used in synthesized ammonia. Which is used to synthesize ammonia, we don't know. What are all the procedure and steps involved in synthesizing ammonia also, we don't know. This is a poorly drafted claim. It is used to synthesize urea, other ammonia fertilizers. So, and used as a laboratory reason, used to produce. The use claim we don't allow in India, but it is a poorly drafted claim. That's a, for example, I told you. Now, this is another claim. The claim, the process and schematic heating of cooling drinking water using. See, he has to describe and define all the parts, all the parts present in this device and how it is working, how it is connected one with other. And finally, the end result he had to describe. Instead, simply he claimed the process and schematic heating. So therefore, he has not claimed anything, and patent office also will not claim anything, allow anything, and this application definitely will be rejected. See, this claim, a novel unreported compound. I said, if the compound is not reported, then you try to file it as a synthetic, and if you say it is separated from any organic, any herbal source or any Rameswaram plant or any other plant, and definitely you will get a method for separating, but not the compound. But if you want to get product patent for the compound, definitely you have to claim differently as a product patent by disclosing a synthetic method. The words from Pamban, Coastline, Rameswaram, Ramanathapuram, it is not necessary. And also the way of writing the claim is also not as per the procedure, preamble, and next connecting word, then the subject matter he has to disclose. And the second claim, it has potential to inhibit formation of AGE confirmed in vitro. This thing also he has to claim differently. And the final example, see the principal claim, it is not properly drafted, and the secondary claim also not properly drafted. See the background information, nothing. Field of invention, he said sales of two-wheeler, and it is not as per the requirement. And if it is not, the specification is not as per the requirement, simply we will make section 10.4 objection, and there is no enabling disclosure. Therefore, the application will be summarily rejected. So, before filing the patent document, ensure that it is properly drafted. If you have any queries, I have covered within this time maximum possible for filing and drafting the patent application. I have not discussed the procedure for filing the patent applications because time is this is 1 hour time. I could be able to discuss at least few points for drafting the patent specification. If you have any queries, you can send to my email ID. This is my office number, direct number and mobile number. You can note down.